Hey everybody, Sharma32 here. Welcome to the channel. We're here today to react to session 9 of Cowboy Bebop. This one is entitled Jamming with Edward. No idea who Edward is. I'm assuming we'll find out. You would think so. I don't know what I'm talking about. But last episode was really good. Like, every episode of the show is so good. Like, I would like, the guy was annoying me at first. Rocco? I want to say Rocco. I want to say that, like, Spike said Rocco, and not Rocco. I'm not sure. But he was really annoying me at first, like, going a bit, he was just too overeager, because then he's really sweet, and I was sad he died. I got emotional. And his poor sister as well, like, not knowing, like, how good of a guy, never getting to see him either. I felt really sorry for her, and him. He was doing it all for her, but Spike gave the seeds back, and, like, it seemed like he funded it, or he got the, no, he funded it from the bounty for the other ones, I think. That's what it seemed like, which is the right thing to do, because the plant got destroyed, which sucked. But hopefully she got the seeds, or she got some of the seeds so that they could take some of the seeds, sell them, that kind of thing, you know, or help give them to somebody else. I would like to think they would have done something good with them, you know, maybe get a little bit of money for themselves. But I'm assuming they got some money from the bounty, which is good. They seemed like they actually got to turn in a bounty for once. They actually, hopefully, got some money. And hopefully Faye won't spend it all. Or gamble it all. Wouldn't surprise me, though. As long as Ayn gets some food and she doesn't nick it, I'm still salty at her for that. I'm going to hold on to that for ages. I cannot help myself. But I'm interested to see what this one is, who Edward is, and we're going to get going because I love this show. So if you enjoy this reaction, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Give the notification bell a tick. You know when the next episode goes live. Let's get going with the reaction in 3, 2, 1. Let's go.
Okay. Nobody here. Always alone.
Oh, subtitles automatically went on. I know they don't work. Always alone. What the hell? Is it... Oh. Drawing something in the... What? You're not telling me that all those designs you see in the desert in is it America? Are a space station. Or worse. Or is it just recreating something it saw in its historical databank?
38 is sunny.
Okay, that was random. I just wanted it to say... Dave. I haven't seen the film, but I know... I can't remember what it's called.
Chance of rock showers this afternoon, 10%.
Okay, who are they? Whoa! Oh god, that would hurt my eyes. So they're not looking up at the sky, they're looking at this in those glasses? Earthgate? They're looking for Bebop? Vacation?
Alright,
huh? Why are they looking for the Bebop? What the fuck? Oh my god, what the hell happened?
Chance of rock showers today upgraded to 90%.
You don't fucking say. Oh, is that Earth? Is that the
The mysterious land carvings that have appeared suddenly in the off-limits area formerly known as South America. For a complete in-depth analysis, here's our expert on the supernatural.
Me, Yuri Kellerman, of course.
So, Yuri...
Oh, God, is that a... Oh, is that really like an actor?
What can't I tell you about them, Tom? They're definitely a message. A secret message from beyond.
Is this from the past? Wait, is Bebop set in the past?
We know the land carvings were created by lasers coming from a man-made satellite. A satellite that has been orbiting in a dormant state for many decades.
Oh, that's confused my head. Are we saying that Cowboy Bebop is set in the...
Wulong reward for the culprit. That's a very substantial bounty.
Distant past.
That 8 million bounty is part of a government conspiracy. Even if they were carved by satellites activated by a hacker, aliens may have planted the...
Was it that person we saw? Was that person Edward?
Yeah, what's the problem? She's all gung-ho about this thing, you know.
I'm not the type to be led around by a woman.
Hey, watch it.
Yeah. Wow, I'm really surprised. I'm a tough guy like you afraid of hackers.
Hackers are boring. and chasing him's more boring.
Hackers are nerdy, pasty, tubby little geeks with triple-thick glasses.
Not all of them. Stereotyping like he's stereotyping a woman. Or Jet
so
was.
So catching him will be a breeze.
Is that right?
Underestimating, I have a feeling, because I'm assuming it's the redhead that did it.
I'll expect a souvenir from planet Earth.
Nothing good comes from the Earth anymore.
Okay. Is this set in the past or the future? I'm confused.
According to informed sources, the satellite is from an earlier era. The investigation has been delayed because the binary access codes are missing.
Oh, okay.
Can you tell us about the relationship between the Earth and the hacker?
Yes, of course. As a result of the catastrophic gate accident 50 years ago, moon rocks began to shower the planet recurrently.
It must be in our future, because the moon.
The people of Earth
broken.
Built a network of supercomputers. These computers allowed them to stay in contact with those who were living out in space.
And those computers became prime targets for hackers who sharpened their skills breaking the codes, thus creating a new breed of hacker with awesome powers.
Okay, so is this set in the future, and maybe this person was putting those pictures back? Because it was, I know it was in one of the Americas. I knew it was. I couldn't remember. I really couldn't remember. But are they putting it back because maybe it got destroyed at some point? Because the moon's broken apart. Okay. Why did they want the Bebop? Why the Bebop? Did they do this to draw the attention?
Radical Edward!
Radical Edward. Okay. What was it? Oh, they're cute.
No. What's wrong?
Oh, what are they doing? Whoa. Sector callback. Bingo. Holy crap, they're powerful.
Oh, no!
That's impossible.
They weren't joking about, like, superpower type things. Like, that's so cool. Like, the fact that they could do it that quick. Okay, that would do my head in. Because now you're stuck here with those police. Okay. I like them, but I feel like if they could, the show could go too far with like that childlike personality and like make it a bit annoying. Hopefully they won't go too far. Ein, wake him up. Oh, Ein.
Bebop looking for hacker bounty head who caused land carvings. Satellite from days of old, lead me to your access code.
Okay,
let's start with all the transmitters that are online right now.
Okay, well, I bet Edward's gonna have it hidden somehow. There's a lot. Or are they using all those transmitters to like make it difficult?
Yeah, it's probably Ed, bro. He's a big mother, like maybe 7 feet tall.
A hacker with a beautiful yet whimsical technique.
Everybody's gonna say different.
Edward's only 3 years old. A freak of nature who loves horrible pranks, I hear.
Okay. Did they ask everybody to say something different? Are they protecting Edward?
Satellite that got hacked into. Tell me where you are. Ed wants those coordinates.
Did Edward actually do it, though? Is it gonna turn out that Edward never actually hacked them?
But there hasn't been any contact from Earth at all. Only relays from other satellite transmitters.
So it did it itself? Is it an AI? Is it an artificial intelligence?
Nobody here. Always alone.
Inside Ed's head? Inside the system?
Oh, I like that too. Is it Close Encounters that thing's from?
Ed's a net diver from Earth.
Earth?
Yeah, right.
Don't say too much. I think you're going to make it risky.
I am the central processing unit on the D-135 artificial satellite.
Artificial intelligence. It's Hal, isn't it, from that?
Long, long ago, long before the gate disaster, Earth was a beautiful planet where people lived in the hills and valleys.
Cool.
And by the rivers, lakes, and seas. Back then, there were many ancient carvings like...
Okay, it's just putting them back.
So to remember those times, I tried to create the carvings the way they used to be.
Oh!
Nice, okay.
Hey, can Ed draw something too? What's wrong?
What's wrong?
This is... The police are jamming my signal.
What?
Oh.
Hey, thank you!
I feel like MP's gonna defend Edward.
Nobody hacked into that satellite. The data proves there's no break-in.
Since when do we have an interactive channel?
Wait a minute. What's MPU?
A friend of Edward's. Satellites.
What are you saying? That you know Edward?
Mm-hmm. Because Edward is Edward.
Huh?
Ugh, there's no time for games.
I like them.
So no one has even thought of checking it.
Then the bounty's not on a person. It's on that satellite.
Since MPU's access codes can't be used anymore, you'll have to actually go to the satellite. Then create a direct link and download MPU. Easy, huh?
Oh, they're gonna get MPU as their, like, ship computer.
If you don't, all the attack satellites will pick up your signal and open fire. There's zillions of them and they've all got kill lasers. Wow, is this too hard for you?
I like Edward.
More like impossible. It's like trying to play baseball without a bat.
To help MPU.
Now this is the kind of stuff I like. Let's do it.
Yeah, Edward. Edward can do it, because I think Edward and MPU will want to protect each other, I think. Oh, I hope MPU becomes our ship computer.
Oh, jeez. You really are Radical Edward, the one they talk about.
Uh-huh. What have you heard?
They're cute. I like them.
They're expensive.
Yeah, right.
1,200 to target.
All right, prepare to shut down your computer.
What if MPU thinks they're fully attacking?
That satellite was acting all on its own. It's the bounty head. There's no
I'm
hacker.
Worried, though, that MPU might be something they need to destroy.
Ed wants a favor in return. If you do it, Ed won't take any of the reward.
Oh, well now, aren't you a nice kid?
Is Edward the final member of the team? Are they going to want to join? Oh, please. Oh, I don't want to watch, though. I'm worried. Come on. Be careful, Spike.
Someone.
No.
You hit it?
Did you?
No, it saw me coming. An attack satellite blocked my laser blast.
Yeah, oh no, Spike. Run. No, or fly away.
Then we have to take out all the satellites in the sector.
You've got to be
guys.
Kidding.
If we don't, they'll take us out.
Gotta use that. It's expensive, but it's self-defense right now.
Oh, the cheap ones are worthless.
Maybe? Oh, Edward needs to get in contact to say that they're trying to help.
This is impossible. Huh?
Jet, approach to 20 meters of MPU.
Then what?
Have Faye act as a decoy to cover.
Why me?
Thanks, Faye.
Edward has got faith that Faye can dodge. That's the word I was looking for. I don't know what I thought that was. Whoa.
All right.
Make my head go funny. He really does look like a character from Voltron when he's in that. I really need to properly watch Voltron. Whoa, that's close. Well, Spike, come on, buddy.
Hurry up! They're all closing in!
He's helping.
She's all yours.
Thank you. He really does look like a character.
We meet again.
MPU, they have a bounty out on you. But we'll just make a copy of you. Then we'll let them catch the copy and you'll be safe. You must be lonely out there, MPU. If you let us
I'm worried about
you,
MPU.
You'll be with us. And
like,
we'll
I hope MPU's good, but I'm worried because it reminded me of the Close Encounters. I'm worried that it's gotta be something that is not good. Edward?
We have a strange ending to a strange case.
Edward,
the criminal
you okay?
was apprehended.
But I still don't know why it carved pictures of weird creatures and all. What in the world was that all about, huh?
That's easy. It was lonely, so it drew some friends.
Yeah. That's sweet. I like that Spike understood that. Oh, good. Edward's okay.
Right down here! Hurry up! Hurry! Promise!
Oh, God. I think Edward's gonna get on their nerves.
It keeps yelling something about a promise?
Some promises are made to be broken, in fact.
Don't you fucking dare. Oh, Edward!
I'm coming for Ed. Ooh la la.
Make them. Yeah, make them land. They made a promise for him. Gotta keep it up. Bitch.
Why are we going down there? What's going on?
Just what did you promise the kid, Faye?
Oh, please tell me Edward's the final member of the team. I will love that. just to see them antagonize Faye.
To become a real member of Bebop.
Oh, please. Hey, Big Shot back. Okay.
The term bounty is legal context, only applies to her computers as life forms. Legal precedent is clear. Biological logistics rejects the assertion.
Roundup time, sugar.
Yes, please.
It's bad no news. Bounty. They won't pay no bounty on no computer, no how.
Oh, so the Bebop's not going to get the bounty. Fudge.
Do you know that there are three things that I particularly hate?
Really?
Kids, animals, and women with attitudes. So tell me, Jet.
Oh.
Why do we have all three of them neatly gathered in our ship?
Ed loves Miyoko's.
Did, Mpew put that on the...
You're a girl.
Like I said, nothing good ever comes from Earth.
Aww. I like that one. Like, Edward seemed to, like, ride the line, like, almost getting too annoying. Like, it might do at some point with the their personality, but it was almost too far, and then they reined it in a bit. I like them. They're cute enough. They're still cute enough, and I'm hoping they can antagonize and add a good thing, because they're going to come in freaking handy, because can't Edward, like, hack and get them some money? You know? I know it's stealing, but... they were owed that bounty. It was promised. There was a loophole. That loophole wasn't disclosed beforehand. Maybe they can find a way to get some money, but I really like that. I really did. That was really good. And I'm assuming Edward is the final member of the team, so I should be able to look at the credits from now on. I'm hoping so. Yeah, I like them. They're definitely going to come in handy with the team, with everybody, because that is going to be some valuable things. But does that mean Mpew? They downloaded it. It was into that floppy disk, wasn't it? So is Mpew still in that space station alone? If Mpew's in that space station, then if Mpew does anything, the police and people will know that Mpew's still there. Or can, now it's been like detached from the rest, can the space station just float off into space, and then when it's far enough away from Earth, use something like some kind of jet propulsion to go off into space and explore? Or did they get another copy and Mpew can now be their computer? Because that would be freaking cool. It will creep me the hell out, though. So I'll be expecting it to turn evil at any point because of the fact it sounds like Hal. I really need to watch Close Encounters. I'm 38 and I can't believe I've never watched it. I need to watch it at some point. But, I like that one. I really like it. And I cannot wait to see what's going to happen with Edward now on the team. And I'm assuming we're complete. That's what it seems like. Yeah, I love that. I would love to know what you guys thought of the episode. What was your first impression of Edward and Mpew and everything else on Earth? Yeah, if you enjoyed the reaction, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Give the notification bell a tick. You know when the next episode goes live. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you again for the next one. Bye.